Hey everybody, thanks for being here. Today we're targeting Coho salmon at Astoria on the Columbia River with guide Frank Russell. Now if you want to learn how to catch more fish, stay tuned. I'm Justin Wolf and this is Angler West Television.
We're down here today for some late season coho fishing. The Chinook season's closed below Tongue Point. You can't go above Tongue Point. Today is the last day for that, but the coho have been here thick the last couple days, so we're gonna do our best to catch hatchery coho only. All the reports I got, they've been biting very well. We're gonna head over to the Washington side and fish what they call the humps, just across from the rest area in the shallow water. We'll start there, and then if we don't catch fish, we'll move up river and find them. It's incredible right now. We got the premium tides. The fishing's been outstanding the last few days, and there's virtually nobody here. If we see 20 boats today, that'll be a lot. This is the way I do a whole herring. I insert a toothpick right between the nose there, hold the mouth shut. I put one hook under the dorsal fin, one hook just behind the gill plate. Slide that up just a little bit. So half inch, bend the head way over, pull it tight. One more half pitch, pull it tight. So I want the front of the herring bent and I want the back of the herring straight. That gives me a nice tight roll. You bend it all the way around, you get more of a loop. We like a nice tight roll here. Okay, we did put an Oregon tackle skirt above it, give it a little more traction. These silvers are what we're mostly gonna catch. They do like pink a lot, and that little UV glow really gets them going.
So what we're going to do today is we're going to drop down a school of fish. We're fishing in the middle of September, and there's not a lot of pressure out here, but it's some of the best fishing is going on right now. They're getting really good numbers in the boats, and there's just not a lot of pressure down here. It's a beautiful day. I'm surprised more people don't get involved in this later fishery down here. It's just some of the best epic fishing that it's been in a long time. So. We're going to show you guys how to come out here in the middle of September and catch fish. So on this rod here, we're using a school of fish down to a salmon sniper. So a salmon sniper's got an interchangeable blade, and it also has a scent chamber in it. And what I like to do, instead of using a whole herring, is I just take a fillet, come down here like this, and I just cut a nice little fillet off. Then I take this back hook, come right through the tail, and spin that thing in there without sticking your finger with a hook. And all you have to do is hook that upper hook right through the meat. So we got this Angler West scent chamber magic, and you just insert it like that. You fill that full of scent, like, look at that. You're gonna have a nice trail. You got your meat here, and we'll drop this in the water, and catch a fish.
Okay, we're in pretty shallow water here. What we'll do is stagger our baits. The back leads are lighter than the front leads. We're in 15 to 20 feet of line right here. So we'll have about 20 feet with the back ones, 15 feet up front. This is what they call the humps. We'll be in 16 feet of water. We'll drop right to 20 feet. We're gonna come back up to 16 feet. These fish lay in these humps here in current. And we'll just make it past two and see what's here.
If you look at this in the water, it actually looks like a bait fish swimming through the water, and then you've got your bait right behind it. So they base it on sight, smell, and you've got all that going right here, and vibration. So you got the blades vibrating, you got the visual of the fish coming through the water, and you got the smell, so with the scent chamber. So when you drop that down, you gotta just increase in your odds. The more of those things you've got in the water, the better your odds are catching fish.
Let me give you a quick one on how to put this stuff out. When you fish these flashes, real important, put the bait out, the flasher, then the lid. Make sure nothing's tangled up. When you put it out, I'm gonna give you a depth. And I don't want you to let it free fall like that. I want you to pull it to the number I tell you to. Let it free fall, they'll tangle up a lot. Control, put it out, no problems. I'm gonna drill close to the bottom, hope you get a bite right away. Go about 18, Greg. Go 15 up front.
Welcome back to the Columbia River. I'm Justin Wolf. Our attractors are working well as we're getting multiple hookups on either herring or Oregon tackle salmon sniper spinners. But getting those hookups to the net is always the problem with coho salmon.
Need a bait. Yeah, we just got stripped from a fish, so I'm gonna rebait. Back hook behind the dorsal, front hook behind the gill plate, tighten the slider up a little bit, half pitch, bend the head over tight. One more half pitch, that'll make it spin good. Now to get the fish's attention here, we'll throw a little procurecin in it. I like to just put it in the body cavity carefully. Be careful, these needles are sharp. That's a little procurianus.
Yeah.
You chewed it.
Yep. Bit her pretty good. Busted her, time for a little replacement.
You know, coho are famous for that. This time of year, they're not really feeding anymore. They're heading up river to spawn. Some days it's drive you nuts. You can get 30 bites and catch 5 or 6 fish. Next day you get 30 bites and catch 20 fish. But you're always gonna have short biters of coho. Not so much with Chinook, but these coho are terrible. Now one of the things I try to do, it seems to help, is not get the back hook too far back. You get them back here, they come up and grab it and pull the hook out and don't get the hooks in their mouth. Keep further forward, he may grab it there, not feel anything, and take another bite. Right here.
Got him.
Got him?
Got it, right.
Okay.
There you go.
Just got off.
You don't want to set the hook. What happens when you set the hook, the fish is facing this way, and you can pull the fish.
Got a fish. There he comes. There he is.
Got him?
Reel him up. There he is. Well, middle of September, no wind blowing, perfectly flat out here. And there's a really good coho bite going on. If you look at that, you can see that school of fish working back there. And
we'll see a fan.
First fish of the day. Nice hatchery coho.
So first fish of the day was with the rod, with the school of fish and the salmon sniper. We had the scent chamber full of Angler West Magic, the scent that they use. And here's the proof right there, works.
Nice little fish.
When you're hooking up these school of fish, you want to make sure that the lead line doesn't come below or else you'll get tangled up. So you have a swivel and a slider right here. It comes right up to the swivel, down to your school of fish. And then we trail behind with a salmon sniper with a scent chamber in it. And I'll put a little piece of fillet on the end of that and drop it in the water. Just you got a lot of scent and looks, vibration, and it's producing fish. The scent chamber, or the school of fish, come in two different colors, green and pink. Pink tends to work better for the coho, or the silver salmon, but we've got green on the other side of the boat, and they've been hitting that too. So today it doesn't really matter if you got pink or green; they're just attracted to the vibration and the visual of the school of fish in the water. So we just hooked a fish and boated it, now we're going to refill the scent chamber. They last a good 20 minutes. They'll sit there and leach out for 20 minutes. There's still residual in there. Even after it's all leached out, you still have scent coming through.
Well, I'm using a number of chain swivels here. These barrel swivels I like a lot better than the round ones. I've been using those the last few years. These are the fish fields here. They got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 beads on them. They work as good as any ball bearing swivel. They're a lot cheaper to use than ball bearing swivels, and they hold up well in the salt water. I don't fish without this type of swivel on my hooks anymore.
We're in 25 and it's shallowing up as we go this way. Yeah, I'd stay at 15 feet. Never feed a fish. First of all, as tight as you get the drags, you about pull the rod out trying to feed them.
No, that drags at the target.
You want to catch fish, leave them tight. When they bite that, let's check that bait. There's teeth marks in it.
It's looking good on it.
You still want to check it always. The back hook can be pulled out. What we found the last couple years, by keeping our drags tight, we're getting a lot more fish in the boat. Now, today it's not working very well, but we're just getting short bites for the most part. We're not hooking fish and losing them. We're getting bites and missing them. But generally, leave that drag tight and then keep the boat going straight, you'll keep catching on the line. You know, these guys here all fish quite a bit. They're not going to have a problem, but I get people from all over that never fish. They get slack in the line, so by keeping it tight, keep the boat moving, I'm artificially keeping tension on the line. So the main reason I'm doing that. Just put another bait on. These are herring. I ordered a couple dozen pounds of anchovies, which I really like for silvers, but they didn't have when we needed them. They did replace them with some small herring, about the anchovy size. And we are getting bit off.
For today's fishing, we recommend the Cousins Columbia Composite Series 955 TG rods, Daiwa Lexa 300 line counter reels, P-Line 50-pound XTCB braid and 20-pound CFX leader, Gamagatsu 4-odd octopus hooks, and Procure Brine and Bite Complete and Anna's Bloody Tuna Oil. I hope you're enjoying today's episode from the Columbia River, where we're targeting coho salmon. And the hot attractor for today is definitely the Oregon Tackle School of Fish. Now, there's three types of school of fish. You've got the original full size, which has about an ounce and a half lead head. And then you've got the full size floating head or foam head and the mini, which was designed for trout and kokanee anglers. However, salmon anglers have really picked up on this mini, and there's a lot of, and they're using them quite a bit. So they're not just for kokanee. Now in today's fishing, we're using the Angler West Scent Chamber Magic in the Oregon Tackle Scent Chambers. Now the Scent Chamber Magic is something that I came up with years ago, which is a concoction of all Procure products except one little secret ingredient, or the accelerant, which makes everything bind together and work well. But basically, it's a way of getting water-soluble oils to the right consistency to fill a scent chamber that don't leach out too quickly. So the way this works is the Oregon Tackle Scent Chambers come with a couple of straws, usually three or four straws in each package, and those straws fit right in the nozzle of the Scent Chamber Magic or any 2-ounce Procure bottle. You can put any of the Procure oils in the scent chambers. And what I like to do is leave that closed so you don't accidentally squirt it out. And the scent chamber hangs so the bead on either one, the bead goes towards your lure. And there's a hole towards the top of the scent chamber right here. So that nozzle fits right in there, and then you can open it, fill it, close it, and then you don't get any accidental spillage. And it just fills right up, and boy, it works great. The original formula is sardine and krill. Now, what doesn't like sardine and krill? This is also really good for marinating your sardine fillets if you're wrapping killer fish. And then we've also got bloody tuna, which is Procure's best-selling scent. And it's just an awesome scent, so why not do bloody tuna as well? But in the those coho in the episode, they were like in the original formula, the sardine and krill. Now, how do you store these things? Okay, well, the Fishfield lure and flasher bags are just awesome. They open up, you take your school of fish, you fold it down, you put it in, and boom, it's safe, secure, you can rinse it. If you're out in salt water, make sure you rinse them, let them dry, hang. And then when you're ready to go, they pop out of there and they're ready to go. Now these wires are very springy and they'll come back to shape, but you can also bend them out however you want them. I know Doug Hayes, the owner of Oregon Tackle, he really likes to bend his out like that. And I like them a little more down like that. So it's just personal preference. Anyway, let's go back and catch some more coho with Frank Russum in the Columbia River right outside of Astoria.
Guide Frank Russum has us on a pile of coho salmon on the lower Columbia. We know that for sure because the sea lions are keeping a close watch on us.
Let's put a little ProCure in it. It's a combination of ProCure anise and a little Slamola powder. Been working pretty good for me this season. Just had a bite on it, missed it. I'll put it back out and try to get another bite. We're right at tide change, so you don't have much current now. So when the tide's running, the grass forms little rips and being lines. Now it kind of spreads out a little bit, so it's all over the place. But once the tide starts going out again, which will be shortly, it'll start forming little rips. You can avoid them. You see a little white foam, all this foam's all spread out. Eventually this foam will be lines and you can steer around it quite a bit. Lead him away from the motor.
Keep your rod out that way.
Yeah. And there's another one.
No, no, you see it?
Huh? You see a fin?
No, let's see.
I don't think so.
Nope, no fin on that guy.
Hey, you got any more of them school of fish things?
Well, that's two fish. On two school of fish, green and pink, both of them are catching them today. Here you go. That's what a middle of September silver salmon or coho salmon. So I get two baits out of a fish when I'm using that salmon sniper. Basically what I do is I come down and just follow that bone right on back. And when I get to the tail, boom, I come right on through. You got a nice little fillet there. And then for my second half, I can use this. So I'm getting two baits. And boy, these Yeti coolers actually, you get a good cutting board out of it too. So nice little area to work on. To hedge your bet a little bit with these silvers, you got your herring working. And we slide over this little hoochie, that's crystal fly that we make at Oregon Tackle. And that pink and white seem to be the color out here for silvers. And just that little added extra right there, and then you just nail it.
Okay, I just got a call from a good friend of mine. He's fishing up river here a few miles. This has been a little slower than we expected, but he's hooked six fish in the last 15 minutes, so we're gonna go help him out.
Welcome back to the Columbia River. I'm Justin Wolf. We made a move upstream a few miles, looking for the hot bite.
Said start 100 yards below that buoy and you'll get bit before you get to it.
So.
There's quite a few birds up here, and these very small tides, the anchovies come further up river. So they're just feeding off the anchovies. The bigger tides, the anchovies don't come this far. If you look right here, if you can see it, there's balls of bait all over the place down here. All right, those are all anchovies. Take yours down to about 70.
70?
70. I go about 50. Doug, you go 25. I'd stay at 15, John.
Where do you want this one at?
Go 50. Big school of anchovies. It's almost from the bottom all the way to the top there.
Nope, spit it.
Nope, he's still there eating it.
There, you just reel him up. 10 cranks. Go ahead and net him, Danny. No, just net the fish.
Okay. See a fin?
Yeah, I see a fin.
Yeah. Okay, let me go down the bead.
Coming to you.
Leave them in the water if you got a fin.
Yep.
All the wild Chinook and coho right now have to be released. That happens to be a wild coho. It's got an adipose fin.
Swallowed it.
Just cut the leader. That's the best thing to it. When you get them swallowed, just cut it and let them go.
There he goes.
Oh, he's there.
He's on.
I got it. Oh, yeah. You're, yeah.
Hold on.
Keep reeling. Keeper. Lift the rod up.
And let's lift her on in here. It's a keeper. Look at that. Beauty.
Okay. There's a limit.
There's one limit on the school of fish right there. We've only got our third keeper today, and all three fish have been caught on the school of fish.
It's not a school of fish, I'm sure it's a wild one.
I think it's bald. It is.
It is. Okay, sorry to match you, Danny. Good job, buddy. Yo, nice silver. Whoa! That's what I'm talking about.
That's a dandy.
Yeah.
Biggest one we got today.
Yeah. Nice quality silver fish out here and stuff. This is fall fish is all about out here.
I don't know if you... Yep.
There's the school of fish with another hit, another takedown.
Doug, on alert, right there, Doug.
There's a double.
Let's see if he's a hatcher here.
Got him?
Quit wiggling around where I can see him.
No.
You got one?
Nope, he's off.
You got hooked up? Bye, guys.
Still there?
Yeah, he's still there.
Grab the other net if you can.
You know something? I'm just going to hand line this small one. Get a little jack here.
So this is a wild fish here. We're going to let him go right back in. Catch him right out of the net. Yeah, he's pretty healthy. Look at him swimming away. Nice.
Hey, thanks for watching today's episode. You know, without the support of the sponsors, the show would not be possible. So please thank them when you can. Now, get out there and do some great fishing.